Good evening, everyone. Welcome to my place. I found an interesting talk, but it's real short. It's probably about a couple minutes long. I found something in this elder who was giving this talk, and while he was reading about Paul and Jesus and Ananias was dead wrong. So before I get into what I'm talking about, then we play the talk, let's hear what the Bible says. And it's from Acts chapter 9, 1 through 13. And then let you hear it for yourself. And then when you get done, you're going to say, oh my God, how in the world did these elders get their material from when it wasn't from the Bible? It was from Watchtower's headquarters. So let's continue.
Then Saul, still breathing threats and murder against the disciples of the Lord, went to the high priest and asked letters from him to the synagogues of Damascus, so that if he found any who were of the way, whether men or women, he might bring them bound to Jerusalem. As he journeyed, he came near Damascus, and suddenly a light shone around him from heaven. Then he fell to the ground and heard a voice saying to him, Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me? Who are you, Lord? I am Jesus, whom you are
Okay, this first part you hear, Jesus revealed himself to Saul. This was no angel. This was Saul. Let's continue.
Who are you, Lord? I am Jesus, whom you are persecuting. It is hard for you to kick against the goats. So he, trembling and astonished, said, Lord, what do you want me to do? Arise and go into the city, and you will be told what you must do. And the men who journeyed with him stood speechless, hearing a voice, but seeing no one. And Saul arose from the ground, and when his eyes were opened, he saw no one.
Okay. Now, Saul had perfect vision all these years, till Christ confronted him on that road and blinded him. Now in this guy's talk, he mentioned that Saul had that vision from thereafter. No, Saul did not have that vision from that after that incident. So let's continue.
And Saul arose from the ground, and when his eyes were opened, he saw no one. But they led him by the hand and brought him into Damascus. And he was 3 days without sight, and neither ate nor drank. Now there was a certain disciple at Damascus named Ananias. And to him the Lord said in a vision,
Ananias. Here I am, Lord.
Arise and go to the street called Straight.
Now, you notice what you're hearing is someone using a voice to represent Jesus. Now, most Bibles all over the world would say Ananias was talking to Jesus. He was not talking to an angel of Jehovah. Or he wasn't speaking to an angel of Jesus. This was Jesus himself. So let's continue.
Arise and go to the street called Straight, and inquire of the house of Judas for one called Saul of Tarsus. For behold, he is praying, and in a vision he has seen a man named Ananias coming in and putting his hand on him so that he might receive his sight.
Lord, I have heard from many about this man, how much harm he has done to your saints in Jerusalem. And here he has authority from the chief priests to bind all who call on your name.
Go, for he is a chosen vessel.
Now, was this the name of an angel Ananias was talking about? Or was he talking about the name of Jesus or the Messiah? See, Watchtower makes these stupid talks all over the world. None of the elders examine what they're preaching to Jehovah Witnesses. Jehovah Witnesses not even sitting down and saying, wait, hold on, this doesn't make no sense. How can an angel of Jehovah is talking to Ananias when the Bible definitely 100% clear this was Christ talking to Ananias to go help Saul to open his eyes? Let's continue.
Go, for he is a chosen vessel of mine to bear my name before Gentiles, kings, and the children of Israel. For I will show him how many things he must suffer for my name's sake. Go, for he...
So you hear it yourself. Christ was the one who blinded Saul, told him to go to the city. Christ talked to Ananias and told him to go help Saul. This was not an angel of the false god Jehovah. It was not an angel from Christ. It was Christ himself. So enjoy, if you can't stomach this part that was ignorant of this elder giving this talk and not going back through the scriptures and read it for himself. So thank you very much, and leave a comment what you think of this thing I put together in the video you're going to see for yourself. Thank you and have a nice day.
And he explains that so that he doesn't get spoiled or think too much of himself, God lets a trial come upon him. And he refers to this in verse 7, in the new paragraph that's at the first part of verse 7. He says, therefore, that I might not feel overly exalted, there was given me a thorn in the flesh, an angel of Satan to keep slapping me, that I might not feel overly exalted. So what was that thorn in the flesh? Perhaps it was his eyesight. You recall when Paul first learned the truth on the road to Damascus, he was blinded for several days, 3 days, and Ananias was sent by Jehovah to heal his vision. But he apparently had vision difficulties, trouble with his eyes throughout his life. So was that his thorn in the flesh? Perhaps. Or Paul often wrote about the superfine apostles that gave him difficulties, false brothers, right within the congregations, opposers. So was that his thorn in the flesh? Perhaps. He doesn't really say what the thorn in the flesh was, does he? But what he does say, what we can be sure of, is that he three times prayed to have that thorn in the flesh removed, to have that lot in life